God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life.
Neither height nor depth nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Love divine was sent by God to earth in human form. Tonight, we gather to celebrate the life of Jesus to reflect on the events that led to his crucifixion, and to remember his ultimate loving sacrifice.
The final week of his life began in triumph with a great celebration as he rode into Jerusalem with his many followers to observe Passover.
For the Feast of Unleavened Bread came, during which the Passover lamb had to be sacrificed. Jesus sent Peter and John, saying, "Go and prepare the Passover for us to eat."
After taking their place at the table, Jesus took bread, gave thanks to God, broke it, and shared it with his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you."
He also took the cup, gave thanks to God, and shared it with his disciples, saying, "This is the cup of the new covenant. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me."
Remember you.
After the meal, Jesus came out and went to the Mount of Olives, as was his custom, and his disciples followed him.
When he reached the place, he said to them, "Pray that you may not come into the time of trial."
Then he withdrew from them about a stone's throw, knelt down, and prayed.
"Father, if you are willing, remove this cup from me. Yet, not my will, but yours be done."
Then an angel from heaven appeared to him and gave him strength.
In his anguish, he prayed more earnestly, and his sweat became like great drops of blood falling down on the ground.
It was there in the garden that Jesus was arrested and taken before the high priest.
He was tried, found guilty, and sentenced to death by crucifixion.
A wooden cross was strapped to his back and a crown of thorns placed on his head.
And he was forced to walk the road to Calvary to be crucified.
Is this?
Jesus was nailed to the cross, and it was raised to the sky.
Yet even in his agony, he displayed selfless love, praying, "Father, forgive them, for they don't understand what they're doing."
No greater love has anyone than to lay down one's life for one's friends. Two other criminals were also crucified with Jesus, one on his right and one on his left.
One of the criminals railed at Jesus, saying, "Aren't you the Christ? Save yourself and us."
But the other rebuked him, saying, "We are getting what we deserve, but this man has done nothing wrong." Then he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom."
And Jesus said to him, "I tell you the truth, today you will be with me in paradise."
Yeah.
it was about noon, and darkness came over the whole land until 3 p.m.
While the sun's light failed, the curtain of the temple was torn in two.
Then Jesus, crying with a loud voice, said, "Father, into your hands I commend my spirit."
Having said this, he breathed his last. The body of Jesus was wrapped and placed in a tomb. The chief priests went to Pilate and asked for guards to be placed there to prevent the body from being stolen. Then they took a large stone and sealed the entrance to the tomb. On the third day, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary came to see the tomb. But there was a great earthquake as an angel descended from heaven and rolled back the stone from the tomb and sat on it. The guards were frozen with fear.
Then the angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid, for I know that you seek Jesus who was crucified. But he is not here, for he has risen as he said. Now go quickly and tell his disciples that he is risen from the dead."
Thank you.
God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have a life everlasting.
God showed his divine love to us in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us.
Jesus, thou art all compassion, pure, unbounded love thou art.
Visit us with thy salvation. Enter every trembling heart.